you're on a path in the woods. And at the end of that path is a cabin. And in the basement of that cabin is a princess. You're here to slay her. If you don't, it will be the end of the world. Spirit. You make your way up the short path to the cabin. You'll find the princess within. The interior of the cabin is almost entirely bare. The air is stale and musty, and the floor and walls are painted in a fine layer of dust. The only furniture of note is a plain wooden table. Perched on that table is a pristine blade. The blade is your implement. You'll need it if you want to do this right. You take the blade from the table. It'd be rather difficult to slay the princess and save the world without it. The door to the basement creaks open, revealing a staircase faintly illuminated by an unseen light in the room below. This is an oppressive place. The air feels heavy and damp, a hint of rot filtering from the ancient wood. If the princess really lives here, slaying her is probably doing her a favor. Her voice carries up the stairs.
Who's there?
She sounds dangerous. It's almost as if she's the one in charge down here.
Don't let it fool you. It's all part of the manipulation.
Oh, are you now? Why don't you come down and let me take a look at you?
Great job. You gave away the element of surprise. Good luck, hero. You walk down the stairs and lock eyes with the princess. There's a heavy chain around her wrist, binding her to the far wall of the basement.
She's so coldly beautiful. Is she really a threat to the world?
Focus on the task at hand.
You weren't kidding when you said you were here to kill me. That giant knife you're holding kind of gives it away, doesn't it?
The blade! Of course she doesn't want to talk. Who'd want to have a conversation at knife point? We should drop it.
Don't you dare. It's fine. We can decide what we want to do after we talk to her. Maybe she really is a monster. Killing someone in cold blood isn't very becoming of us. You ignore the trembling in your hands and tighten your grip on the blade.
You poor thing. Your hands are shaking. Are you scared of me? Because you should be.
You step forward, your grip on the blade tightening as you steel your resolve.
I'm probably chained up in this basement for a reason, right? And if that knife is the only weapon you have, you'll have to get close enough to use it. So, you should just drop it. Best not to risk finding out what I can do.
She's unarmed. If you hesitate now, it'll be too late. End this. Doubt, unfortunately, clouds your thoughts as you attempt to run her through. A moment of distraction and hesitation is all she needed to sidestep your thrust and deliver a catastrophic blow to your jaw. It feels like you've been hit with a sledgehammer. You can feel bone grinding on bone where your jaw has been fractured. Holy shit, that hurt! Though she's unarmed, the shock of that first strike is enough to stagger you, putting you and the princess on somewhat equal footing. Your blade slashes through the air again and again, and her fists connect with your body as many times or more, each impact as heavy as that first bone-crushing hit. We can still turn this around. You and the princess stare at each other, both gasping for breath, equally exhausted. You probably won't make it out of here alive, but you can at least make sure that she won't make it out of here either. Excuse me? Do you think this is what I wanted to happen? I have a duty to state the facts of the situation, and honestly, it's a miracle anyone is still standing right now. Can you not feel all those ruptured organs bouncing around in there? If the princess doesn't do our friend in herself, internal bleeding is certain to finish the job. The two of you clash for the final time. You feel your ribs break as she delivers a heavy blow, but you push through the pain, falling forward and sinking your blade deep into the princess's heart.
Oh.
The two of you fall to the floor.
This was fun.
The princess gasps, her voice an unhealthy rasp as her lungs start to fill with blood.
You put up more of a fight than I thought you would. But I have to wonder, do you really think this is the end?
But you don't have time to worry over such things. Everything goes dark, and you die.
You're on a path in the woods, and at the end of that path is a cabin. And in the basement of that cabin is a princess. You're here to slay her. If you don't, it will be the end of the world. Assure you that you didn't slay her and that she didn't kill you. People don't just spring back to life after dying, and the two of us are meeting for the very first time. If he doesn't remember what happened, then maybe it's best to keep it that way. You know I can hear you, right? It's going to be a lot harder than you think to keep secrets from me. That's fine. It doesn't matter if he can hear us. The only thing that matters is marching up to that cabin and winning. That's the spirit. There's no point in squabbling when the real threat is just up that hill. Those are two very different questions, but fine, I'll indulge you if that's what it takes to get you moving. Let's say for a moment that this really is the second time you've met me, or at least a version of me. You died last time, which probably only happened because you didn't listen to me. We did our best with the information we were given, and we did kill her. And yet you still died, didn't you? So congratulations, you've been given another chance to actually do this right. And I believe your other question was something along the lines of, oh, what's the point of doing anything? If you're asking that, it sounds to me like you're making the rather dangerous assumption that your actions last time around didn't have any consequences. What do you mean? Of course there weren't any consequences. We killed the princess killed us, and now everyone's right back where they started. That sounds pretty consequence-free to me. Yes, but in this purely hypothetical scenario, that begs the question of how you got back here. Did time simply rewind itself, or were you instead transported to a different world entirely? Had you failed to slay the princess, what would have happened to everyone in the place you left?
Ugh, enough with the talking. We've got a fight to win. Nothing else matters.
I couldn't agree more. The cabin and your destined confrontation with the princess awaits.
A warning before you go any further. She will lie, she will cheat, and she will do everything in her power to stop you from slaying her. Don't believe a word she says.
Lying and cheating doesn't sound like her at all. Not that it matters. It's not like she can lie or cheat in the middle of a fight.
Are you sure about that?
The point of my warning wasn't to start an argument over what circumstances the princess is capable of lying in. It was to give you some broadly applicable advice. The princess will do and say whatever she thinks it will take to get her out of there. So don't trust her. Ever. Are we clear?
Crystal. Let's just get on with it already.
The cabin is tighter than its exterior would suggest. Its cold stone walls press in on you, as if trying to forcefully direct you towards your destination. The only furniture of note is a black iron altar, with a pristine blade perched on its edge.
See? Even the cabin has the right idea. Let's get moving.
The blade is your implement. You'll need it if you want to do this right. You take the blade from the altar. It would be difficult to slay the princess and save the world without a weapon. Walk up to the wall next to the basement door. It's a wall. There isn't much to see here.
What are you talking about? This isn't a wall. It's a mirror.
You reach forward and rub your hand against the cabin wall. I hope you know how ridiculous you look right now.
But there was a mirror a second ago.
Now it's gone, so all of us can stop arguing about it and get to fighting.
The door to the basement creaks open, revealing a rough stone staircase, its walls pressing at your sides and tightening as you descend. The air seeping from below is heavy and oppressive, with an almost sulfuric odor to it. If the princess lives here, slaying her would probably be doing her a favor. Her fierce voice carries up the stairs.
Is that another challenger? Finally! It's been ages since I've had a good fight.
This isn't what she sounded like last time. Her voice is a little deeper, almost threatening.
Good. Sounds like my kind of princess.
As much as I appreciate the enthusiasm, just make sure you don't let your bloodlust get to your head.
You need to stay focused and keep your wits about you. Remember, you're here to slay the princess, not to have a good fight. As you descend the final step, the form of the princess comes into view, a large shackle leading from her wrist to the basement wall.
Looks like she could rip those chains out of the wall without a second thought.
Oh, it's you again. I'd been hoping you'd find your way back here. Good to see that death doesn't stick for either of us. And you brought your little knife, too. Yes! I'm going to have fun breaking you into little pieces.
Free her? You aren't... I don't know why I'm even bothering, to be honest. You know the stakes of the situation.
Who says I want to be free?
Are you really just gonna... not say anything to that? If she doesn't want to leave, doesn't this whole situation just work out for everyone?
There's nothing out there for me. The only thing I care about is right here. All I want is to keep knowing what it feels like to kill you and be killed by you. I want to feel that knife split me open. I want to feel your bones snap beneath my fists.
I think I'll just... let the princess speak for herself here. Leaving her in the basement isn't an answer. You have to make a choice.
And there's only one choice worth making. Fight her. Win.
Okay, fine. Let's say for a moment I believe you. For all we know, whatever happened to you last time was just a fluke, and beyond that, do you know who doesn't remember anything that happened last time? Me. I don't remember what happened last time.
Are you okay?
Of course I'm not okay. As far as we're all concerned, the fate of my world is still very much on the line. Not all of us have the luxury of jumping over to a parallel universe the second we die.
Oh, I remember you all right. Best 3 minutes of my life. So, why don't we do it again?
See? She wants to fight us again. There's no reason for us to stand around talking.
I'm sorry, did I hear that right? Did you just say you're going to try and free her?
She doesn't even want to be free.
Exactly. So beyond the apocalyptic moral implications of letting her out, how do we even think that's going to work? I mean, we have a weapon, right? We could always just cut her out, yeah? While she's trying to kill you. Yeah, why not? And then what? Do you think she'll just follow you out of here?
Maybe.
I don't know.
It's worth a shot, isn't it?
No, it's not. Actually, no, you're not. I have a responsibility to the world here, and I'm not just going to let you throw yourself into a scenario where the literal best outcome is the end of everything. Until you come up with any other idea, your body remains standing rigidly in place.
What do you think you're doing? You can't just order our body around like it's some sort of doll.
Watch me. Your left arm lifts towards the ceiling and your hand twists into an obscene gesture. See? I can make you do whatever I want.
So what? You barely managed to lift our arm.
What are you doing? What is that? Why are you moving so weird?
The princess, taken aback, flashes her own rude gesture in return.
Hey, you, decision maker. I want us to fight her as much as he wants us to kill her, but this is boorish. Just ignore him. If you want to try and free her, I don't think there's much he can do to actually stop you.
You know what? Fine. Blade in hand, you charge forward to try and free the princess from her bindings.
Finally. I have no idea what you were just doing, but I'm glad it's over.
Slash across her wrist, her elbow comes crashing down on your skull. An unsettling crack echoes in your ears. It's a devastating blow. Your body crumples to the floor, limbs suddenly refusing to respond. This might be it.
That's it, huh? You've gotten really soft.
Everything goes dark, and you die.
Really? In just one blow?
Yes.
Oh, come on, that's hardly fair. We're not dead. You're just flipping the table over.
It is what it is. You're dead. Finished. Over.
All right, fine. This whole thing's a frustrating mess anyways. We're better off with a fresh start. I'll see you two next time.
You're on a path in the woods.
If you weren't so damn focused on freeing her, we wouldn't have died back there. You're strong, but you're bullheaded. This isn't a fight, it's a puzzle. She's stronger than us, but we can use that to our advantage. I hate puzzles.
Yeah, of course you do.
I've never done a puzzle myself, but anything that doesn't get us beaten to death is good in my book. What do you have in mind?
Same thing as last time, only we'll be smarter about it. We're getting her out of there. After that, we're seeing what happens.
Are you insane? Do you have any idea how dangerous that would be? If she gets out of here, that's it. Game over for everyone, yourself included.
Are you not challenging us on all the looping? Have you known about it the whole time? Are you the same one we've been talking to since the beginning?
Sorry to disappoint what I'm sure must feel like a grand revelation, but that's not what's going on here. We've never met.
Enlighten me, then.
I have no memory of meeting you, but you've clearly seen things you weren't supposed to have seen. You'd only be saying the things you've been saying if you'd already been here.
Mm-hmm. So where does that leave us?
It leaves us exactly where we started, and where I'm sure you've already been before. The princess, left unhindered, will bring about the end of the world. You have to put a stop to her, and the only way to do that is to slay her.
But we didn't stop her last time. We died. Yet here we are in a world unended. A different world unended, to be sure, but there's still solid ground beneath our feet. What the hell are you going on about? Even if he isn't lying, reality clearly continues to be real. So I want to see what happens when she leaves. I think we all need to see the truth.
You absolutely do not need to see that. I've already told you the truth, and the only thing to see after she leaves is the end.
Screw it. I'm sick of this smug asshole telling us what to do. If you need help busting her out of there, I'm your man.
Welcome aboard. And if things go bad once we get her out of the cabin, well, at least you'll be able to get the fight you wanted.
The rest of you had better keep those two in check. They're far along the edge of a dangerous path. Don't let them go any further. It's evidence of one of many ticking clocks. You can't let her spread any further.
But do we know it's her? For all we know, he's in control, pulling the strings to make us too afraid to do anything but slay her.
For all we know, it could be us making the changes.
Exactly. And at least, as things are now, there's no way for us to know. But the world is clearly not as it seems. We can't trust anything until we learn more.
If you question reality itself, there's not much I can offer in the way of persuasion, but do consider that it probably isn't helpful for anyone to doubt the ground they stand on. It isn't long before you find yourself at the end of the path, staring up the hill at the cabin. I hope you've given serious thought to your predicament.
No last advice for us? No words of warning?
From what I gather, you've heard it all before. There's no use screaming into the wind.
I don't know. Screaming sounds pretty good right about now. I could use a little catharsis.
There'll be time for that later. For now, you know what you have to do.
The interior of the cabin is suffocatingly tight, more of a glorified tunnel than a building. Its stone walls squeeze against your sides, leaving you no choice but to press forward. The only furniture of note is an iron altar jutting out from the wall, a pristine blade perched on its edge. The blade is your implement. You'll need it if you're going to do this right.
But there's nowhere to go in here. This is just a hallway with a mirror at the end of it.
A mirror? But there isn't a mirror here. There's the iron altar, the blade sitting on the altar, and the door to the basement. Does he really not see it?
Or maybe what we see as a mirror, he sees as a door.
It is a door. And before you ask, no, it's not a mirror-shaped door. The object at the end of this room is both door-shaped and a door. There shouldn't be any room for misinterpretation.
Who cares what it is? It's in our way. We should smash it. Take it.
You take the blade from the altar. It would be difficult to slay the princess and save the world without a weapon.
Good. Wouldn't want to be pushed around without a way to push back. She likes when we can push back, doesn't she?
You step forward and approach the door to the basement, hesitating before you open it, as if you don't see it. You're rather committed to the bit, aren't you? The door's right there, it's right in front of you.
This really is just like last time.
Can you really not see the mirror? Or is pretending it doesn't exist another one of your rules?
There isn't a mirror. Is it a rule to say that there isn't a mirror when there's clearly one right there? Because if it is, it's not a very good one.
I'm inclined to agree, but we don't know how things work here, do we?
Just smash it already.
Bring your fist crashing down against the door leading to the basement. It swings open, scraping against the floor as it reveals the dim path ahead.
Why am I not surprised?
It was in our way, and now it's not. That's all that matters.
Before you is what may as well be a sheer cliff face. There are enough footholds that you'll be able to clamber your way to the bottom, but it will require careful effort. The air hissing up from below is warm and wet. Her voice, bold and fierce and impatient, echoes from the chamber below.
Do you have more fight in you than last time? That was such a disappointing show. I know you can do better than that.
She hasn't changed as much as she did the time before.
She still wants a fight, which means we still know her. We can use that to our advantage.
That's not how this works. I'm all chained up, remember? How about you come down here and fight me?
Don't worry about the chains. I've got a plan. Yeah, we'll just have to get her to break them. You've nowhere to go but down. You start the difficult journey, gripping the stone, lowering yourself foot by grueling foot. But soon, there is solid ground beneath you. We best remember how to get back up. The last thing we want is to be stuck between a wall and a raging devil. You turn to face what lies at the end of the narrow tunnel. The princess, imposing and tightly muscled, grins back at you from the darkness. Her face widens into a broad grin.
There you are, knife in hand. How thrilling! Attack me, bleed me, twist the blade in my flesh, break your bones against my body. I want a real challenge this time.
If we're trying to break her out, I doubt she'll come willingly. We'll have to use ourselves as bait. I really don't like the sound of this. It's the only way to get us both out. And we need to see what happens when she leaves the cabin. You know what? I should have tried to intervene earlier, because I can't let you do that. I won't tough sh- It's not the... Yeah, doesn't feel nice to be yanked around against your will, does it?
Well, what are you waiting for? If we're going to do this right, you can't be scared. You need to want this as much as I do. So go on. Make the first move. Don't keep me waiting. We've talked plenty. I'm sick of talking. I'm sick of waiting. I'm sick of you standing just out of reach and teasing me with a fight you won't let me have. You disappointed me last time, so you don't get to choose what happens next.
Bloody desire in her eyes, the princess rushes forward, ignoring her chains as they bend and snap. Okay, she's taken the bait. Now let's get out of here. Without hesitation, you turn back the way you came and scramble up the ledge towards the tunnel entrance. As you near the top, hands desperately clawing at jagged stone, you glance back. The princess is right on your heels. She doesn't bother to scale the wall as you do, instead digging deep into the rock of the cliff face with her fingertips in her rabid pursuit.
Anywhere you go, I will follow.
We're planning on it. You reach the ledge and hoist yourself up into the tunnel, the cabin door finally in sight, at once within your grasp and infinitely distant.
What is all of this for? What's the point? You and I are always going to end in violence, so why bother to run? I know what I am. Why can't you be the same?
You continue to the door. It'd be a real shame if it were stuck. Don't listen to him. Locks are nothing. Just barrel through.
No!
Your skin hums tight with adrenaline as you burst through the cabin door and roll onto the grass. You bastard. You glance back at the cabin as the princess, singular in her desire to destroy you, explodes through the doorway. So, this is what the end looks like.
What is this place? Where are we? This doesn't feel right. It's cold. Why is it so cold? I feel so tired.
She's gone. Where did she go? Should we try and find her?
Oh, there's that mirror again.
Why is it here? Why now? But it feels so bad. Like looking into it right now is going to be the end of everything.
You're right. Part of me wants the truth, but something stronger is holding me back. Fear. Screw the mirror! We just need to find the princess!
Okay. If you say so. We'll trust you.
Maybe there'll be a good fight there. Maybe we'll find her again. Feels too good to be true.
There's a world beyond the endless walls of the Long Quiet. We're supposed to be there. Do you know what we'll find out there? There is a warmth and sadness in me at the thought of people. Fresh tears on a winter's day. They are not like us. They do not last. We are real. Nothing is an idea that dwells in the absence of something. But nothing cannot exist on its own. And because of that, nothing can't exist. This one yearns to grow and struggle. Even now I feel a will pushing against mine, not realizing that we are one. She will make for a fierce heart. Do not mourn her. We will provide her with the growth she fought for.
Thank you.
No, their thoughts are quiet. Do you think your narrator lives in the spaces beyond? To one who fears me for your truth. The only answers worth knowing are those we can find within ourselves. One, whatever you bring me next will be enough, and then gravity will pull the others back to me. I will be singular, a final multitude. You've already tried waiting, but I understand if you need more time. I'll wait with you. I will see you when you return. What textures will you leave for yourself to occupy forever? Will you place the images of you and I into a box for safekeeping? If you close that box, will you become another you in another world? An imaginary pattern repeating itself until it can no longer bear the weight of its hand-drawn cage? You'll always come back to the box, because you'll always want to know what it means to be you. I will be here waiting by your side until you're ready to return to mine. Though you were gone mere moments, I never left your side. These gifts are a conversation, and each one shows me the contours of your heart. The only thing I want to see is what you choose for me when the thread is fully drawn. The next time I see you, each of us will finally know what we are. I will be here, waiting for you.